President Noynoy Aquino remains relatively scandal-free in his 3 years in office, something Filipinos may not be used to following two former presidents who were plagued with corruption allegations. Teddy Locsin Jr. ponders on that in tonight's Teditorial.
Looking back on 3 years of Noynoy, looking forward to three more years of the same, he appears to have done nothing much. Yet a great deal seems to have been achieved. A growth rate of 7.8% is pushing up against GMA's record of 8, but looking to be more durable. This raises the question, is it necessary for a president to do a lot, or is it enough for him to be clean? We believe that unless presidents steal, they won't do anything else, so nothing will be achieved. The country won't move, except backward. And if one step forward, two steps back, maybe for extra side-to-side like rumba. But there is a satisfying feeling while the music is playing that a whole lot of motion is going on. And then the music stops. And the only persons with chairs are the president, his family, and their bag people. Before Noynoy, and despite his mother's antiseptic example, we had dirty presidents, but consoled ourselves that dishonesty was the price of activity. At least they got things done, even if only for the kickbacks pocketed by them. We have accepted that electing crooks to higher offices gives them more reason to steal from positions where there is so much more to steal and much less risk of getting caught by someone higher. There is no one higher than a president himself. Noynoy has apparently not stolen. There isn't a whiff of scandal about him, on top of which, he likes leaving things well enough alone. If it ain't broke, why fix it? And yet the economy is jumping. Even if businessmen believe that fixing what ain't broke, better yet pretending to fix it, makes a 100% profit. So, can we have a president who is good for the country without having to be more good to himself, his family, and friends? Must we accept that for a president to do anything, he must also steal, like a shark must keep moving in water to breathe? The last election showed that people appreciated rather than deprecated Noynoying, or doing nothing when there is no need to do anything, or sleeping on the job instead of being up and about in the middle of the night, breaking and entering. This happened before Noynoy. It would have happened again if anyone but he and possibly Gibo was elected in 2010. The last election may indicate that people will not accept a crook in the presidency again, even for the good he may do in the process of having a good time himself. Because if Noynoy can achieve so much without stealing, people may demand total honesty as a bare minimum for the presidency. Noynoy has stamped on the national consciousness that the president can be many things, even awkward or lousy at dates. But we shall never again have a thief for a president if he can help it. Keep well.